In part 5, we spoke about Dube and Gandhi living as neighbors in Inanda.
I read something in the Gujarat Times. They were looking at this whole issue. I mean, people saying that, you know, Gandhi literally didn't pay attention, you know, to the black concerns, which to me is absurd because, I mean, you know, Dube and John Dube and Gandhi, I mean, knew they were pulling in the same direction.
So you see, the planters, a very Campbell was a big planter.
That's right.
And now when Campbell had crucial meetings and parties,
yes,
he would invite Gandhi and he would invite Dube.
Mm-hmm.
So they would be there to represent their respective peoples.
Communities, exactly, yes. And to talk and...
Yes.
Yes, okay. Probably also, they had, even outside of that, being neighbors. I mean, they certainly paid courtesy...
Well, they were neighbors, you see.
That's right.
And they would have been rather lonely men, both intellectuals...
That's right.
And they would have sought each other's company to exchange ideas, to while away their time.
Yes, yes.
They were both men of equal caliber.
That's right. That's right.
So they could easily communicate with each other.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. You know, one theory I have is that they were cautious not to make the intellectual exchanges and political exchanges, they were cautious not to make it so open and as a to brave, to openly challenge the system. So, in other words, discretion, in a sense, was for them a way of ensuring effectiveness to the action. So that way, they didn't have
their survival.
That's right, exactly. You see. So if you can address that a little bit, because see, this is the whole source of the controversy, because there was not too much open expression of that, you know, meeting of minds and in that partnership, there were not so many open documents to prove it or actions, joint actions. So people started saying, well, you know, Gandhi didn't do this, but...
No, that is ignorant people who don't understand anything.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Post facto, they make these kinds of assertions.
Right.
But that is quite untrue. You are dealing here with a young Indian who comes into African territory.
Yes.
He's not a leader, he's not Gandhi.
No, no.
He is Mohan. An untried young man.
That's right.
He's not Gandhi.
No, he's not. Yes.
He's nothing near Gandhi. He is light years away from Gandhi.
That's right. That's right. So he would certainly seek, you know, advice.
No, he would watch Dube with great admiration and see him as a leader of his community. He wouldn't go transgressing and trespassing onto his area. He wouldn't do that. He would do everything possible to help him grow as a leader of his people.
Exactly. Because I came across articles, news articles in Dube's newspaper, the Ilanga Lasi Natal, of Gandhi taking some of his very important Indian visitors, such as Mr. Gokhale, who came to visit him at Phoenix. Dube makes arrangements for him to go visit, and Gandhi
Dube
makes arrangements to go visit his
Dube,
name, which is part of the African tradition and as part of the Indian tradition. You know, when you are settled somewhere, people come and visit you. The first thing you want to do is to take them to meet your neighbor.
Yes.
You see what I mean? So that already proves that these people had a project going, you know.
They were in communication.
That's right. So, yeah.
And the thing is, Gandhi had a press where he was printing his paper with a hand machine.
That's right.
And when Dube's paper couldn't be printed because the machinery broke down, he brought the paper to Gandhi and Gandhi would print it for him. So there was that going on.
Exactly.